Hi, in this video, I'm going to explain about exercise 9.2, question number 16, 17, 18, solution. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Also, click the bell icon to get regular notification. Question number 16. Between 1 and 31, M numbers have been inserted in such a way that the resulting sequence is an AP. The ratio of the 7th and m minus 1th numbers is 5:9. Find the value of m. See, in this question, they have given two numbers 1 and 31. So, between this 1 and 31, we have to insert now m numbers. So, let us say that the numbers are a1 to am. So these numbers now we have to insert in between 1 and 31. So we have like this way 1, A1, A2, A3, AM and the last number is 31. So the resulting sequence is an AP. Now this is an arithmetic progression. That means here the first term is A is equal to 1. And the last term is, see here, it is not mth term, it is m plus 2 term. Because, see here, we have inserted m numbers. So, totally here we have m numbers. Then the first number, that means m plus 1. Then the last number we have to count, that is m plus 2. So, in this AP, totally we have m plus 2 numbers. So, that's why here am plus 2 this is. Or n is equal to a, that n is equal to m plus 2. And in the question, see here, they have given that we have to insert the numbers between 1 and 31. That means the last number is here 31. So, m plus 2 term is here 31. So, now by seeing this AP, we can get these three values. The first term is a is equal to 1. The last term, that is a, m plus 2 term is 31 and n is equal to m plus 2. Totally there are m plus 2 numbers. Why it is m plus 2? Because we have inserted m numbers a1 to am. Then first number we have to count, that means m plus 1. Then the last number we have to count, that is again m plus 2. Now we know that to find the nth term, we have the formula an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. Now, in this formula, replace these values. That is, an is 31 because here we are finding am plus 2. So, 31, then a is 1, then n is m plus 2 minus 1 into d. So, 31 minus 1 is equal to m plus 1 into d. 2 minus 1, that is 1. Then, 30 is equal to m plus 1 into d. So that d is equal to 30 divided by m plus 1. So now here we got the value of d. Next, again in the question they have given that the ratio of the 7th and m minus 1th numbers is 5:9. Find the value of m. They have given the 7th and m minus 1th number ratio as 5:9. Now we need to find out the value of m. See here, first of all, 7th number and m minus 1th number means here, see, 7th number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is the numbers which we have, that is starting from 1, 2 up to we have the last number as 31. But they are telling about the ratio of the 7th and the m minus 1th number. That means here you have to consider the number which we have inserted. See, we have inserted the numbers starting from A1 to AM. So, in this A1 to AM, the 7th number is which one? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, this is the 7th number. But if I consider the AP series, in this case, this 7th number is in which place? 1, the first number is here, this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, in the case of AP, this is the 8th number. If we consider the inserted number, then this is the 7th number. But if we consider this one as a 1 AP value, together this one we consider as a AP, then the last number is 31 and this is in the place 8th position. So, this is the 8th number. So, 8th number. The seventh number we can take as eighth number. In the same way, m minus 1th number means, see here, this is m minus 1th number. This is in the place, this is in the position, that is mth position. You can see that here, A7 means it is in the 8th position. A6 means it is in the 7th position, plus 1. So here we have am minus 1, that means this is in the mth position. So we need the ratio of A8 divided by am, that is equal to 5/9. So this we have to find out, a8 divided by am. If you write here a7 divided by a minus 1, then this is totally wrong, because in the question they are not talking about the ap term, they are talking about the numbers which we have inserted, and we have inserted a1 to am number. So these are the numbers which we have inserted, that is the number in between A1 to AM. That is the reason that here I have taken A8. You can't take here A7 and AM minus 1 directly, because these are the numbers. That is, we can write A7 and AM minus 1. A7 and AM minus 1. So now we have to find out A8 and AM. So to find this one, again use the formula, that is nth term formula. AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. So this become A plus 8 minus 1 into D divided by A plus M minus 1 into D, that is equal to 5/9. This is given in the question. Now let us try to simplify this one. A plus 7D divided by A plus M minus 1 into D is equal to 5/9. And we know the value of D, that is 30 divided by M plus 1. So just put that value, 1, and A value also we know, that is 1 only. The first term in the AP series is 1. So just put that value, A is equal to 1 plus 7 into 30 divided by M plus 1 divided by 1 plus M minus 1 into 30 divided by M plus 1. That is equal to 5/9. Now you can here consider this one as a, here you can take the LCM, that is M plus 1. If you take the LCM as M plus 1, this become M plus 1 plus 7 into 30 we have here. 7 into 30, that becomes 210 divided by, again you can take the LCM here. See here we have M plus 1, take the LCM, so this become M plus 1, then M minus 1 into 30. So here we have 30 into M minus 1, that is equal to 5/9. So this become 210 plus 1, that is M plus 211 divided by this M plus 1 and this M plus 1 will get cancelled. So we have here M plus 1, 30M minus 30, that is equal to 5/9. So M plus 211 divided by M plus 1 plus 30M minus 30, this is. Then M plus 211 divided by, this become 31M minus 29 is equal to 5/9. And then this and this you can multiply, this and this you can multiply. So 9 into M plus 211 is equal to 5 into 31M minus 29. So multiply this to this. So we have here 9M plus 1899 is equal to this with this, 155M minus 145. So then add the values, this you can bring to this side, so that 1899 plus 145 is equal to 155M minus, this you can bring to this side, minus 9M. So we have here 2044 is equal to 146M, M is equal to 2044 divided by 146, that is M is equal to 14. So we got the value of M, and in the question they have asked us to find the value of M. Next, 17th question. A man starts repaying a loan as first installments of rupees 100. If he increases the installment by rupees 5 every month, then odd amount he will pay in the 30th installment. See, we have to find out that what amount he will pay in the 30th installment, that we have to find out. So they have given that a man starts repaying a loan as first installment. That means here the first value is 100. The person is first paying the rupees 100. Then after that he has to increase the installment by 5. So the next number is 105. Then 110, 115, like this way. And like this way he has to pay till the 30th installment. That means the last number is A30, we can say. So now we know the series now. See, from this To this you can apply directly the AP formula, arithmetic progression formula. This is the first term. Then the common difference is 105 minus 100, that is 5 only. You can see here between each term the difference is 5. Then n, the last term is your 30, that is A30 we have to find out now. In the question they have asked that what amount he will pay in the 30th installment. So A30 we have to find out. So we have the formula to find out the nth term. An is equal to A plus n minus 1 into D. So just replace the value. A30 is equal to A is 100 plus n is 30. 30 minus 1 into 5. That is A30 is equal to 100 plus 29 into 5. So that is equal to 100 plus 40, 145. So A30 is equal to 245. So the person has to pay the 30th installment last amount as 245. Next, question number 18. The difference between any two consecutive interior angles of polygon is 5 degree. If the smallest angle is 120 degree, find the number of sides of the polygon. See, polygon means we can have in different shapes like hexagon, pentagon. So different types of polygons we can have. So here in the question they have given that the difference between any two consecutive interior angles. The interior angle polygon difference is given. See, first let us see what is interior angle and exterior angle. Suppose if I take a hexagon, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 sides we have here. See, these angles, that is from here to here, that is this one, and these angles are known as interior angles. The angles inside the shape. Suppose if, let us say that here you have some line. So now here some angle is formed, or here if you have some line crossing this one, then here some angle is formed. This is known as the exterior angle, the angle outside the shape. So now in the question they have given that the difference between any two consecutive interior angle, any two interior angles if you take, then the difference is given, the difference is 5 degree that they have already mentioned. And in the case of polygon, to find the sum of the interior angle, we are using this formula, that is n minus 2 into 180 degree. For example, see in this shape, we can have 4 angles, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now the total angle of this shape you can find out by using this formula, that is n minus 2 into 180 degree. See here, the n means here, see 1, 2, 3, we have here 4 sides, so 4 minus 2 into 180 degree, that is 2 into 180 degree, that means the total angle sum is here 360 degree for this shape. In the same way for this shape, you can find out the total angle sum as 6, that is 6 sides we have here, 6 minus 2, that is 4 into 180 degree, that is 720 degree. Like this way, you can find out the sum of the interior angle of polygon by using this formula. So now, this is the formula we have to use to find the sum of the interior angle. And here, see, they have given that the difference between any two interior angle, that is already given 5 degree. So that we can take here the common difference as 5 degree. And see, they have given the smallest angle is 120 degree. So the first angle, that is the smallest angle, that we can take as A, that is the first term. So A is equal to 120 degree, D is equal to 5 degree. And to find the sum of the polygon, we have to use this formula. Then if we apply here the AP arithmetic progression, then in the case of arithmetic progression, to find the sum, we have the formula Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Now this we can equalize with this one so that we can write it together, that is n minus 2 into 180 degree is equal to n by 2 into 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Now here in this formula, replace this value, a is equal to 120 degree and d is equal to 5 degree. So we have here n minus 2 into 180 degree, this 2 we can bring to this side so that it will come in the numerator into 2 is equal to n into 120 degree into 2, that is 240 degree plus 5 n minus 5. Then this become n minus 2 into 360, that is equal to n into 240 minus 5, 235 plus 5 n. So that we have here n minus 2 into 360 is equal to, here this become, here you can take 5 out so that we have here, if I take 5 out, then 47, 5 47s are 235, so 47 plus 1 n. Then we have n minus 2 into 360, this 5 you can bring to this side, 360 divided by 5 is equal to n into 47 plus n. Then we have here 360 divided by 5 is 72. So n minus 2 into 72, that is equal to 47n plus n square. Now you multiply this to this, 72n minus 144, that is equal to 47n plus n square. So n square plus 47n minus 72n plus 144 is equal to 0. So here we have n square minus 25n plus 144 is equal to 0. So now you can find the factors. See, here we have 144 and minus 25. So when we multiply any two values, we have to get 144, and when we add the values, we have to get minus 25. So such two numbers we have to find out, and such two numbers are minus 16 and minus 9. If you add minus 16 and minus 9, we get here minus 25. In the same way, if you multiply minus 16 and minus 9, we get here 144, that is plus 144. Now put these values in this place. So we have here n square minus 16n minus 9n plus 144 is equal to 0, that is n into n minus 16 minus 9 into n minus 16 is equal to 0. So you can take the common values out, n minus 16, then n minus 9 is equal to 0, n minus 16 is equal to 0, n is equal to 16, n minus 9 is equal to 0, n is equal to 9. So the final value for n is here, n is equal to 9 here. So if you like this video, please like and subscribe. Also click the bell icon to get regular notification. Thanks for watching.